Welcome you all to this lecture of video where we are going to talk about extended surfaces. As we have already discussed critical thickness of insulation, one more part of this module is extended surfaces. What is extended surface? Why we have to extend the surface of any body and how it affect all these factors we are going to discuss in this video. Always the means are often sought to improve the heat dissipation from the surface to its surrounding in many engineering application. As we are moving towards new development, new technologies, we want many features in a compact manner. So if I'm going with a laptop, if I'm going with a mobile, I want to have all the features, but from the thermal point of view, when I'm having all the extra features in it, the heat dissipation or heat generated will be very high. Unless and otherwise I make a means to remove that heat from the generated body, it will otherwise affect badly the body which is conducting that heat. Therefore, we always find the ways to have the heat rejection done by the surface to its surrounding so that our equipment or any system works properly. The heat conducted through the body must subsequently transfer to the colder body by convection. So heat transfer within the body takes by conduction, and heat rejection that is taking place should be by convection. So we have seen, if the outer surface or outer fluid which is surrounded by our equipment, if it is having the higher heat transfer coefficient, then the body which is generating the heat will be cooled very easily or cooled very faster rate. Hence, the analysis of a combined conduction convection heat transfer is quite important. What is conduction and convection? Conduction is that taking place within the body because of the thermal conductivity. A convection is the heat transfer due to the external surface which is surrounding that body. The heat transfer is quite important from the practical viewpoint. When a solid of a relatively small cross-section area protrudes from the large body, the fluid at a different temperature. So our analysis now, it is concentrated on conduction and convection. Of course, we are not at all considering radiation heat transfer. We are assuming there is no radiation heat transfer that is taking in this account. So the protruding surface is called as extended surface, or here it is called as the fins. In the above diagram, you can see a cylinder body which is having the extruded portion from the outer surface. This is the piston and this is the piston rings, and these are the extruding part which are helping for the heat which is generated inside to reject to the atmosphere very easily. And one more application we can see, this is the condenser of an air conditioner and refrigerator, and this is the oil cooler or radiator. Everywhere we can see a mesh type structure where it is having the fins or extended surface on its surface for easier dissipation of heat into the surrounding. By this, the heat which is rejected will safeguard or save quality of the equipment is taken into account. One more application we can see over here is the body of a motor. In this motor, the external body, right, has been extruded, and here this extended surface acts like the fins. Even when we see in electronic equipments, the semiconductors or diodes or any other setup in the electronic, this one, we can see the extruded portion over the part of the actual working nature of the semiconductors are been given so that heat dissipation or the heat rejection can take place easily. This is very, very essential and required for the day. And often new experiments, new strategies are employed, because everywhere we can find the electronic items are coming, and these electronic items should reject the heat very efficiently, and a convenient way has to be found out for the dissipation of the heat. The rate of heat transfer due to convection we are given by the formula of Newton's law of cooling, and we know that Q is equal to H, where H is a convective heat transfer coefficient, A is a surface area, T is the delta T, or Ts minus T infinity is nothing but temperature of the surface and that is of the surrounding. The temperature of the surface, the temperature of the surface is fixed one. So which is the generating body of the heat, which is other the that cannot be reduced. So if I want to increase the Q, one way is to increase the value of H, other way is to increase the value of AS, or to get the higher value, I have to increase the TS. I cannot think about increasing, but delta T, right? Delta T or difference should be in a higher range. So these are the different possibilities, and let us see what is the pros and cons of doing each of them. So if I have to increase this T surface to be, which is fixed one, so there is no point of increasing or decreasing the T surface, that is one is a fixed one. So here the convective heat transfer coefficient, if I have to increase the H value, we know that, suppose if I take the H for a free convection, it is in the range of 5 to 10 watt per meter square degree centigrade in the normal condition. If I'm using an external agency, say a blower is used or a fan is used, of course H value can be minimum from 52. It may go in 3-digit number, 100, 150, 200, 250, depending on the turbulency that the fan is creating. Of course, by this way, I can actually increase the velocity and I can increase the H value. But by doing this one, the two factors I have to remember. One is, I have to give the initial cost, that is, I have to buy the blower or a fan, which require a cost. And second one, to running cost, to run that fan, because we know that a fan is a work absorbing device. So it have to pay, or to pay for the electric bill or electricity for doing so. So H, by increasing H, surely the Q value can be increased, but in this case it is not justified. Only the reason is that by increasing, that is a running cost and initial cost will be increasing. And moreover, if I have to place a fan over a semiconductor, the external agency will be having more bigger than the body from which the heat has to be rejected. Mean to say, the floor area or the space required by the fan or the external agency will be much more higher, which is not justified. Therefore, the increasing of H value is also not of a good justification. The next option is to reduce the T infinity. T infinity, as we know, it is the surrounding temperature or the temperature which the body is exposed to. So we cannot reduce the ambient condition, right? It is actually, it is a natural condition, and which it is not anyone cannot make an attempt to reduce the T infinity. Therefore, I cannot, as told earlier, as TS is the or T surface is fixed, T infinity is also fixed, which we cannot do in a reduction. So only option now left is increasing the surface area. So here I can do increase of area, but if I do the increment of area, suppose I am taking the example of a IC engine, and if I want to increase the area of this one, there are so many parameters. TDC, BDC, or stroke volume, even the firing order, or the firing firing required parameters will be already designed and it has been implemented on the body. So I cannot alter any the parameter within the engine cylinder. So the next option which is left out is to do certain operation, or I have to do certain things external to the cylinder. And if I have to do that external cylinder, that is only is protruding the body, by which my surface area will increase. Moreover, it will also increase the Q, that is a heat rejection. So our problem of increasing the Q can efficiently dealt by extending the surface or having a fin on the body, as discussed. So to increase the convection heat transfer coefficient H, as we discussed, we may require a pump or fan, and it requires a more cost and a more area. Therefore, that has been rejected. So that approach may not be practical, hence we are not using that one. Otherwise, we can use that concept of to increase the Q value. To increase the surface area, AS, by attaching the surface, extended surface, are called fins. And these extended surface are highly conductive material such as aluminium. Why we are using aluminium? The aluminium is used only because it has got a higher thermal conductivity. Second one, it is having the very light weight. And third one, it is less costly. So, and easy to fabricate also. Keeping that in mind, the aluminium is the material which is frequently or which has been used in the commercial field. So here you can see the body of a dinosaur where for cooling it is having the fin-like structure on its body, which otherwise to keep the body temperature warm. So similarly, in the human bodies, we can see the hair, right? The hairs are working like the fin body, which is an extended surface for cooling our body. So if it actually to safeguard the heat, and the heat dissipation through the hair on the body or hair on the head will be helping out for the heat dissipation from the body. So these are some more examples. We can see the diagram of a radiator over here, so that on the radiator body also we can see the fins attached, which is easier for the heat transfer to take place. For our derivation, let us consider a elemental strip of having a length L, and we are considering here, if you consider, this is a three dimensional one, and it is, if I consider this as x direction and this is a y direction, and if I go with the third one, it is a z direction. So here the heat is transferred. If I'm, this is a base, or this is if I'm having a source over here, heat will be coming and heat will be rejected to the tip. If you see, this is a uniform body. Uniform body means there is no taper we found from the base to tip. It is having the uniform configuration, one thing. Second one is, since it is a material, and we know that in the solid body, the conduction mode is very, very dominant. Therefore, here the conduction takes place from the body. And since this body is exposed to the outer field, I have the air over here, and the air over here takes the heat from the body, and that is a convection mode. So for our easy understanding, let us take the small strip in this element, that is called, this is an elemental strip, which is having the thickness of a delta x. So this is the heat which is been given from the base or the source, that is qx, and heat which is coming out will be qx plus dx, and this, the elemental strip, is exposed to the outer ambient condition or outer surface, which is having the heat convective heat transfer coefficient h, and we have taken T infinity as our surrounding temperature. So one is heat given is Q conduction, and heat rejected is a Q conduction plus Q convection. So this is my elemental strip delta x or dx, which is at a distance of x from the base, and other parameters have been shown here. So this is if I have to consider the perimeter, this is the perimeter of this elemental strip, and area, this is a AC, is considered as a cross-sectional area. The assumptions made here is a steady state heat conduction. The first assumption in this derivation is done is, it is a steady state heat conduction. Second one is, no heat generation within the fin, means within the body there is no heat generation. The heat generation is considered within the body is very negligible, so there is no heat that is generated within the element. So uniform heat transfer coefficient over the entire surface of the fin. The h value, what we have discussed in earlier one, that remains, it is, there is no change. Sudden practically there will be a little changes we have seen as the velocity of the air increases, the h value also varies, but for our easier understanding, here the h value is considered is uniform throughout the body. Homogeneous and isotropic fin material, that means it is made up of a single material, and thermal conductivity of the material is same. There is it is not made up of a different combination, right? It is not made up of an alloy of having nickel and copper, or nickel or other combinations have been not used. We are taking the base material and the fin material are same thing, that is a same thermal conductivity of the material. Next one is a negligible contact thermal resistance. The thermal contact resistance means the gap or the void or the space between the body and extruded person is negligible. It is not having any void or no space or no air gap have been found over here. Heat conduction is a single dimensional, 1D. 1D means I am considering from the heat transfer is taking place from one direction only. So here we are considered as a QX and QX plus DX means I am not considering the heat transfer that is taking place in the Y direction, or I am not considering the heat transfer that is taking place in a Z direction. So I am considering only one direction. And moreover, I am also neglecting that heat by which is taking place due to radiation. In order to determine the differential equation for a fin, right, from the body, if I have to see what is the differential equation that is going here, let me take this is QX as defined earlier, that is heat given at this junction, and this is a heat rejected QX plus DX. And since this end is having the some fluid, say air, it is having convective, Q convection, right? If I have to find the differential equation, first I have to see what is that heat that is a QX given given to the elemental strip, and QX is a, now it is a conduction, and we know that the law of conduction is Fourier law, and it is can be given as a K into A, where A is a cross sectional area, and dt by dx. So it is a dt by dx at a x, right, at a x. And second one, if I have to see what is the QX plus DX, what is that one? The heat rejected at this point, the Q at the source and Q at the tip are not same. If I have to estimate that, I can use minus K into area of the cross section with the dt by dx, and that is a x plus a dx. This is a x plus dx. And the third one, if I have to estimate what is the Q convection, right, at the tip, since I have given H is the convective heat transfer coefficient and area, and that is the temperature difference delta T, that is a T minus a T infinity. And we know that the area here is not a cross-sectional area, it is a surface area. Moreover, if I have to find out the surface area, I can use P into dx, perimeter into dx, instead of area, and this remains the same, T minus T infinity. And applying energy balance, if I have to apply the energy balance, what is meant by energy balance? Energy balance is nothing but the heat given to the system should be equal to heat that is rejected out of the system. In this one, QX is the heat given, QX plus DX is the heat rejected plus Q convection, right? Q convection. So if I do that one, it is an energy balance. And I can use to make my mass easier, I can make the Taylor's series or Taylor's expansion. Taylor's expansion, if I just make a brief note on Taylor expansion, what we have studied earlier in mass, that is if it is a dx by dt by dx at x plus dx can be given as dt by dx at x plus d by dx at dt by dx by x dx plus d square by d x square, and it is a dt by dx with the dx to, and so on, it continues. Substituting the Taylor series, what you have studied in the last one, substituting the Taylor series in a above equation, we can simplify further, and that is now my equation will become K into area, that is a
cross-sectional area dt by dx, right, at x should be equal to minus k. This is due to which is going the heat rejected, right, from the tip, k into cross-sectional area with the dt by dx at x minus, I'm using the Taylor series, a into cross-sectional area with the dt by dx at, now it is a square, right? I've seen how the Taylor series works, and it is a dx square, d square t by dx square into dx plus a convection, that is a h into area. Instead of area, I'm writing p into dx t minus t infinity. If you can see here, these two things, the first k minus k this is a common, so I can cancel this one, right? They are equal. Now, if I transfer the second factor, this is the second factor, this is my third factor, right? If I transfer this factor on the left hand side, what I'll get, the minus sign will become plus, that is k into area, that is cross sectional area, and it is a d square t by dx square. What I've done, I've just brought the second term on the left hand side, and I'll bring the third factor, that is a convection, that is h into p dx t minus t infinity is equal to zero. Now, if I divide entire thing by k into a cross sectional area into dx, right? If I divide this one entire thing over the above equation, what I'll get? This get cancels, right? K into the first factor get cancels. I left with what? Now d square t by dx square minus h p, and the k into a area cross section is not there. So since I'm dividing everywhere, this dx get cancels with the dx, but I left with the k and area of a cross section, and t minus t infinity is equal to zero. I'm going to define a new term, m square, and m is nothing to do with the mass or anything. This is a, because I know that h is a constant, p is a constant, k is a constant, and area of cross section is constant. I'm going to define a new constant, that is m, and that m square is equal to, I'm going to define as a hp divided by k into ac. If I define so, what happens, I can also tell m is equal to square root of hp by k into area, or this is a cross-sectional area. I can use the above m constant in the differential equation. I can rewrite as a d square t by dx square, and that is equal to m, that is equal to m square and t minus t infinity, or I can also write as a dt square d square t by dx square minus m square into t minus t infinity, right? That is equal to zero. This is my new differential equation. I can also note down, if I assume that t minus t infinity is equal to theta, then I can rewrite that d theta by dx, d theta by dx is equal to dt by dx, or I can write d square theta by dx square is equal to d square t by dx square. So substituting this value, my assumption to the equation, this in a, this equation A in the equation A, which is I written here. So I can make this as a d square theta by dx square minus m square theta is equal to zero. So the differential form can be written as theta is equal to C1 e to the power minus mx plus C2, where C1 and C2 are the constant, e to the power mx. So this is my basic equation for deriving the further derivations.